many areas, like scientific, technological, and economic, in an international scale. Expansion was helped by the English language, because it is the international accepted language. But what is English for a specific purpose? It is an approach of the teaching of English aimed to specific fields like scientific, technological, economic, and academic. It starts and it begins for the need of the students or people in general. In general, that have to communicate with other people or make a business in a certain professional area. Why we choose the finance purpose? English is the international language of business, like I said before, and people have to know the vocabulary of finance to do and to understand the standards and regulations of this area, and that is because we choose that topic.
So we have the most important words in finance. One of the first is investment. Investment is the now alludes to cash that you put into your business, property, stock, or something like that, so as to make a benefit or we make an interest. We sound this word all the days. We use this word all every day. For example, when we invest in something, there since before some years there are new inventions. For example, in online pages in internet, so people who doesn't have money make an invention, and you can invest in these things. For example, we have this. This is like a pillow that can make a hug to you at night. Maybe here in Zamorano, sometimes we feel alone and we feel that we don't have to nobody, and you can use this. It was like a stupid invention when in the first time, but this invention won millions of dollars. This is a Japanese invention made by Tomoki Hakuhachi. And there's these word functions in the world of finance. Later we have this word revenue. Revenue is the measure of cash your organization makes from the sale of merchandise and services. Okay, so this is an easy word. It's only all the money that a company wins. That's all the money. And this word has a division in these two words: profit and loss. What profit? Profit describes the measure of income your organization increases in the wake of bearing costs, expenses, charges, and so forth. The objective of each business is to make benefits. Yeah. And loss is the gains, because it's it's the point at which you lost cash. So maybe in this you win, in this you lost. Obviously, what a company wants is always profit, because if you have a loss in the final of your company, you are, and this is closed. And a good example of this are the movies, because we watch movies all the time, but behind of these movies there are a big companies that all the time are waiting for profit. For example, this movie was like something amazing. Maybe you know it's the Nightmare Before Christmas. Okay, so this movie makes millions of dollars around all the world. So maybe you don't invest in these movies only some hundreds or thousands of dollars. You invest millions of dollars. So you have to profit more than this, and this movie got that. But later, maybe 3 years before this movie appeared, it's the Moji movie, what was awful. So all the money the producers invest in this movie, they couldn't combat this money, so they have a loss in the end of this money, of this movie. So
now I'm gonna talk to you about stocks. And stock is kind of security that connotes proportionate partnership between two owners in the enterprise. This qualifies the investor of that event of the company's advantage and income. What those they refer to? You refer that there are two like owners of a business, and what they do is that they share the cash that comes in, because it's like they are working together. And some people tend to like get confused with two words, with stocks and bonds. I'm gonna talk to you first about stocks, that is the word that we're talking about. And stocks is an equity instrument carrying ownership interest. And bond is a debt instrument with a promise to pay back the money with interest. What do I mean by this? That bond is something that you have to give back. Interest you don't pay. Stocks, sorry, you don't have to give it back, because there is something you are sharing. And also, like I say, in stocks, the money is divided half and half. And in bonds, it depends on the interest and what you get. Remember that you have to like give back the money, so it's a lot different. And then we have the bear market. You know that the name is like really strange, but in this case, it's like a bad situation that might happen in a company. Why do I say this? Because a bear market is when something contrary to something positive happens. What do I mean? That all the budget market, all the costs and everything from the store or from the company comes down, because they're they don't have the sales amount that they want, and they're producing more than the people are buying. So what does this cause? A bear market. Everything comes down, so they have to lower their prices, and they have to lower their production so they can like satisfy the money that they are really using in the investment of this product and to take it back from the things that we buy. Now we have the bull market. In this case, the bull market is something good because the bull market is when the company is on its high speed and everything, thanks to God, they're selling everything that the production they do and they have good news. And so when did the bull market begin? It began on March 9, 2009, the bear market of the low Great Recession. Then we saw it, they saw it again in March 28 of 2013 that finishes 500 above its pre-crisis closing high from 2007. And most recent bear market low by some measures. So like you see this graph, every time that the graph comes down, this can be considered like a bear market. But when the scales go up, this is like a bull market because bull is like the back of the bull that is like upwards, so that's why it's called bull market. And even though graph during time it has like lower, it always goes up and up and up. Now I have capital flight, that is a huge scale departure of money, related resources, and capital from a country because of location, for example, political or monetary, cash downgrading on the burden of capital controls. So capital flight can be illicit or legal. It depends on what those company uses. And you have to be very careful because the capital flight changes depending on the country that you are in. So make sure that if you go to another country, you are following the capital flights that they have. So the last one I have is mortgage. There is a home loan. It's a
is in reverse to the financial complement component that the City Times, particularly companies or the government, use when they are in unfriendly conditions to give money to a company, because too many times in the countries I see difficult situations, and the government use this strategy to reduce taxes and make the external companies give money to national companies. In installment plan, it's a technique when the individual that we want to buy a product, but they have enough money. Then the company gives the product, and the individual will pay this product little by little, and the individual makes a normal installment. He have an obligation to completely pay this product. In a wholesaler, it is a customer that buys a lot of quantity of products and resell the items again with more expensive, and he have more profit. And it's better to be a wholesaler because the price is of our goods, our cost, will be reduced.
Shares is when a company divides its capital.
finally you have a real example.